Hello, my name is Chris. This is my first vblog testimony. It's June 16th, 2012. And so yesterday I was praying, I was talking to God, and I asked Him to use me today and to maybe we could bring some healing and some deliverance and some salvation to some people. And then today I woke up and I felt like I was going to go to the Cinnamon Park, go for a walk. And so I did that, and as I was walking down one of the paths, I saw two guys. One was sitting on a bench and the other guy who was standing next to him, I guess they were having lunch. And I felt like the guy who was on the bench had a short leg, and I was thinking or wondering if I should approach him. I was having like this image in my mind that I was commanding his leg to come out, and that they were going to be touched by God and impacted in a big way. But I kept walking. I kept walking past them, and I just was being, I don't know, kind of doubting if it was God or not, maybe just thinking that maybe I was just imagining things, you know, those thoughts that come at you when the Lord is speaking to you. Sometimes our mind isn't renewed enough, or we're just not being obedient or whatever. But anyway, I kept walking past, and then I got about 20 feet and I was like, no, I have to go back. So I turned back and went up to the guy who was sitting on the bench and asked him if he had back pain, and he said that he did. And then I explained that I felt like the Lord was, like God was telling me that he needed, or that the reason that he had back pain was because he had a short leg, and that God wanted to heal him and wanted to show him that he was real. And actually, I don't think I said that he was real, but that he wanted to heal him. And the man had already stood up at this point and said, "Well, how are you going to do that?" And I said, "Well, if you just sit down and put your back all the way to the back of the bench, I'll show you." And his friend was there too, and I lifted up his legs. He had flip-flops on, so his flip-flops just stayed on the ground, and lifted up his feet, showed his friend. His right leg was short by about half an inch, and then just commanded the leg to come out in Jesus' name. It took maybe about 20-30 seconds, and his friend was pretty amazed. I could hear he was talking to the guy who got healed in their language, and I asked him if he felt anything going on in his leg, and he said he felt stretching. And then I asked him to check out his back, test his back, and he did, and it was better, or healed. And then I just started sharing about the gospel, and then the friend said, "Oh, he probably knows all that already." And I was like, "Oh, you're Christians?" And for some reason, I didn't think they were Christian. I just guess the Lord was, well, sometimes you can tell, right? And it's just, if we're one in the Holy Spirit, then we must have that in our spirit, knowing that there's another person who's one in the spirit too. Maybe that's just a thought that I just had, but anyway, so I shared the gospel, and he was a Buddhist, and I just explained to him how he can ask God to be his Lord and Savior. And you just, if you believe that Jesus raised from the dead, that he died on the cross and raised from the dead, and ask him to be your Lord and Savior, you will be saved. And I just left him with that, and I didn't ask him to pray a prayer. I just like to let people do that on their own, or just make sure that they're aware of what they need to do, and then lead them to it. And then I was going to walk away, and the guy who got healed asked if he could have a picture of me, or take a picture with me. I thought that was kind of funny. I never had that happen before. So I said, "Yeah, sure." And his friend took a picture of us, and while his friend was taking the picture, it was like he was talking to the camera almost as if he was filming. He said, "And today this is the man that introduced us to the healing power of Jesus today." And I just thought that was good. And just blessed them and kept walking. And I ran into a woman who was in a wheelchair, and she could hardly talk. And I thought maybe she was like mentally disabled. disabled, or what do you call them? When someone is born with, I thought that she was mentally disabled or mentally retarded, and I don't know, I guess retarded isn't a politically correct word, but, there was a woman with her, maybe a healthcare aide or something. She explained that she was born with cerebral palsy, and so I was like, well, I just explained to them that I pray for people and God heals them, and I had my I See Healed People shirt on from John G. Lake Ministries, and the worker or friend, whatever, looked at it, and she's like, I heal people, and I said, yeah, well, I see healed people, I showed her, and I explained that it was like a play on words from the movie Sixth Sense, where he says, I see dead people, and I see healed people. And that's a good thing I thought about this afterwards, that the guy who took the picture with me is going to have that on the picture, and they'll see that it says, I see healed people, and then say, see the JGLM.org, so they'll know where to go to get some good teaching, so that's good. And then, I prayed for that girl in the wheelchair, and she felt God doing something, and asked her if she wanted to walk. She didn't want to walk or try to, and I said, well, do you want to try moving your legs? So she tried moving her legs. She could lift them just a little bit, and I said, well, could you lift them more than you could before? And she said, yeah, and I just encouraged her that she's going to keep getting better, and that many times I pray for people, and then I run into them later, and they tell me that they were healed later, so it's not always right away. And then I prayed for her friend or the healthcare aide, and she had tendonitis in her right elbow, and that went away like instant, and she was really encouraged. And I just they were both Christian, and I just shared with them that they have the same spirit of God in them, and that he wants to heal people through them, and just because he put a kingdom on us, just like the Father put a kingdom on him. I was reading that after this in Luke 22 or somewhere around there, where Jesus says that he put a kingdom on the disciples that the Father put on him. And it was just a good day. It was so good to walk with the Lord and just let him use me. And it's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And if I just let him do what he wants to do, then it's an adventure. And I just encourage you all, just walk with him and listen to him, and get your mind renewed on some good teaching, like JGLM.org. They have DHT training. You can find DHT training MP3s online. You can buy them at their web store. You can go to YouTube, find it on YouTube. Andrew Womack has good teaching on healing too, and teaching about the new covenant and how the new man. Curry Blake from JGLM.org teaches on the new man, and Paul's revelation of the new man, Christ in us, the hope of glory, Christ in us, who lives through us, and it's no longer us who lives. So just get your mind renewed, and go out and love on people, and he'll move through you. Sometimes it takes some effort. Sometimes you don't see healing right away, but you just keep doing it, and you just keep commanding their bodies to line up with the Word of God, and just put your faith and your trust in God, and he will be faithful, and he'll do it. He'll heal through you. He'll speak to you about them. You'll prophesy to them, and you'll bring many into the kingdom. And that's your fruit to eternal life. The only thing we can bring with us when we die is other souls. So it's good fruit. It's good work. So do it. God bless you. Okay, bye.